So from looking around me this month, you might have thought that you were joining me at a seance, but as it turns out, following the last video, I had a little bit of feedback asking for some simpler demonstrations as well for students lower down the school. So this time I thought we'd go for something a little bit simpler, and we're going to be looking at the density and the extinguishing properties of carbon dioxide. So let's have a look at a number of different ways that you can do this with your students. So this month we're going to be having a look at a couple of different alternative ways of doing this demonstration. Now the first thing, sort of in its simplest form, of course you can just chuck some calcium carbonate and some acid into the bottom of a beaker and pour it out over a candle. But a lot of the time you might find that if you've got the liquid in the flask already, then sometimes you can sort of end up dripping some of that out. You have to be a little bit careful as you're pouring, and that loses some of the visual appeal. So this month we're going to be actually giving this a try with putting some calcium carbonate into a smaller beaker inside a larger beaker, and then we can actually have a play around with just the carbon dioxide that we're producing and see a couple of different effects that we can produce from that. So I'm going to be using 10 grams of calcium carbonate, and of course if that's completely neutralized, that will produce for us about 2.5 liters of gas, and I've got a 2 liter flask here. It's just a nice round number. Of course you can scale up or down according to your whatever situation that you're working with. So 10 grams of calcium carbonate, and what I have here is two portions of 2 molar HCl. Obviously I've put some indicator in here, as you can see, but that's perhaps just to help it show up a little bit better on the camera. Maybe you're doing something with your students where you're looking at evidence of chemical changes and it might be beneficial to you, but of course it's absolutely not a requirement. The reason I've split this into two different portions is that if you pour in the whole lot in one go, you'll find that the powder reacts a little bit quickly and it will spill out into the larger beaker. So putting this into two portions is going to allow this reaction to go at a sensible pace for us. So pop this inside here. And I've also got, I mean, I'm using a little mini whiteboard, essentially something to act as a barrier or a screen just to stop any spray from coming up into my face from the acid as it's reacting, and also to minimize any losses due to diffusion. So we'll add in the hydrochloric acid, first portion, and see how we get on. So I give that a couple of seconds to react, and as that begins to die down, of course I can add in the second portion. So as I said, this is going to be generating for us about 2.5 liters of gas, so more than enough to fill this flask that I have here. And I give this a little swirl just to make sure it's kind of finished off. So as you can see, this takes about a minute or so to completely finish reacting. That's one of the reasons why, of course, we're using slightly more than we need in order to fill our flask. If you're in a hurry, you'll still have plenty of gas to demonstrate some of the effects to your students. So let's have a look and see if we can take this out. Move that out of the way. Now the nice thing, of course, is that you can now actually have a discussion with your students about whether or not they see anything, or they think that anything is still inside the flask. And if we take the lid off, many might think that, of course, the flask is empty. But of course we have this denser than air gas, and we can see if it has any kind of an effect on some candles that, of course, I've placed here in a tray. And again, sort of obviously the tray here, this is about a 5 liter storage box, and the candles in the lower half should find that at least a number of them go out if we were to pour this in here. And there we go. So our candles go out, showing the extinguishing properties of the carbon dioxide and the fact that it's denser than air, the fact that we can pour it out of this larger beaker. So we can also try and sort of demonstrate the same kind of an effect using a section of guttering, One of the nice things about having a simple demonstration is that you might actually want to use it more than once at different year groups, and so sometimes having a different way of showing the same kind of an effect can be handy. So I'm going to create another stash of carbon dioxide in my beaker, and we can see what kind of an effect we can get running down our guttering. Okay, so here we go, a nice big beaker of carbon dioxide, and we can see what kind of an effect we get down this guttering. And there you go. So we get this cool sort of waterfall effect as the CO2 makes its way down the guttering, blowing out the candles on its way. And we can even go for a third alternative version to this to demonstrate the fact that with the CO2 trapped in a space, it's actually not possible to relight that candle once more. So I've gone for a slightly smaller scale version of this just to illustrate the fact that you can work at various different scales, and because it was just the handiest size beaker that I had available. So in here I've got two candles, and I this time have quartered my scale because I've quartered the size of my my beaker. So I've got 2.5 grams of calcium carbonate in here, and I have 25 mL, which I'm going to add again in two portions, this time with the candles in the same flask. So let's see what happens. So I've got my candles lit, and this time I'm going to add my acid in, and we'll see what happens to the candles as we begin to pour the acid in. And the candles go out. Now, as I begin to add in the remaining part of my acid, just to make sure that I've completely filled up my flask, I can now attempt to relight the candle. So you can see that actually, the splint goes out before I even get in contact with the candle. It's not possible to relight it because we've trapped our carbon dioxide inside. So three different variations on a classic demonstration, one that you can show to a range of different age groups of students and get some good fun out of. Give it a try.